Good morning.
Good morning.
How are y'all doing this morning? Kissimmee? Did I say that right? And Gilbert? And Brianna? Man, where's all the kids at today? We have so many kids in our church and all of a sudden we're down to three. We gotta get some more kids in here. One of my favorite authors describes this vessel as a human agent. This body we carry around is the human agent. What is this body? What is this body used for? What would you say this body is? Why did God create this body? Very good, Brianna. He created it for worship. And our worship center is here in our brain. We worship God in our brains. And our body is used to carry this worship center around. Because there are people that can't get around, but they have their worship center with them always. I want to tell a little side story here. And Brianna brought this to me this morning, and she asked the question. She says, "Granddad," she says, "what is the X before the MAS?" And I told her that the way Satan works in our world, he is taking that word Christ, and he has put an X there. So Satan is taking Christ out of Christmas. Everybody's seen that X. Well, we don't want to do that. When we write Christmas, we don't want to put an X down and take Christ out. We want to put Christ Mass, Christmas. And even people with the word, I've seen people with the word, with the name Christina or Christopher call themselves X Tina or X Topher. Yeah, we do not want to put an X where Christ ought to be. At least I don't want to put an X where Christ ought to be. Now, there's King David. Do y'all know who King David is? Do you know what he did before he was a king? He was a shepherd. And as he shepherded the sheep, he took care of the sheep. And what happened when the lion came up? What did he do to the lion? He killed the lion. And then a bear came. And what did he do to the bear? He protected his sheep from the bear. He killed the bear. Now, God trained David long before he had any giants in his life. And as David went out onto the field to meet this giant, he had blasphemed God. He had how to say this. He was kicking, he was talking again about David's God, and David was upset that he was talking about his God. So David went down on this field to meet this giant, and David was trained to kill. He had killed lions and he had killed a bear, and he knew that he could take this giant because when he was taking care of the sheep, he knew that God was with him, and so he would do whatever it took to take care of the sheep. And when the giant came, what did he do with the giant? Did he trust God as he trusted him to take care of the bear and the lion? So he slew the giant, right? Yeah. So David trusted God. Why did he trust God? Because he was God. Very good. Well, he loved God because he had a relationship with God. And the only way that we can make it in this world, the same as David made it, is to have a relationship with him. Because what does the Bible tell us? The Bible tells us that God is love. And his love shines on each one of us the same. whether we are good or bad, God's love is, God still loves us whether we are good or bad. And he it's like the lights in this room. How am I getting the same amount of light as you're getting? Yes. Yeah, I'm not getting any more light than you're getting. Whether I'm good or bad, whether you're good or bad, I'm still getting the same light. Well, God's love is the same way. He loves all of us the same because he cares for us. Brianna, would you like to come up and read scripture for me? Can you read 1 John chapter 4, verse 16?
And we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him.
Amen. Would someone like to pray? Gilbert? Can you come over here?
Short prayer. Jesus, for good, Mommy, amen.
Amen. Thank you.